We're at the City of Carlsbad on the Lennar track development. Each year, the month of May is designated as Building and Safety Month. This year's themes will include Prevent, Prepare, Protect, and Building Code Safe. Today, we're ready to take a tour of one of these buildings. It's a finished product, it's a final inspection, but I thought we would show important components of a residential home. This home has an address that you can clearly see it's greater than 4 inches, and that is so helpful for the emergency response team and first responders. In the conceptual stage, the architect draws the plans in combination with the engineer, and they bring it forth and submit to the city department, and a permit is started, and then it goes into plan checking. Once it gets approved from plan checking, they can go forth and build. And at that point, inspectors come on board, we go out in the field, and we make sure that it complies to the approved set of plans by the engineer. And this is a component called the inverter. It's part of the photovoltaic solar system and a disconnect. My favorite part about my job is the technical science aspect of the building codes, product knowledge. I love that part of my job, and a lot of other inspectors do too. Right here we have a tankless water heater. It quickly energizes and heats up the water source, so it's unlimited water. Modern codes are always evolving and changing because there's so much to be learned from natural disasters, seismic events. We learn so much, and we adjust the code accordingly on how to protect people and their structures. Another important aspect of this is that the air or any gases exhaust outwardly. You'll notice on the ceiling the expansion tank of the water heater. That is to absorb any thermal heating that's going on in the unit. This is the gas shutoff valve here that's important for maintenance purposes or emergencies that we can shut off. If you notice on the ceilings of this U1 occupancy garage, we have fire sprinkler covers. There's a little device that senses heat, and once it senses it, it breaks, and that opens up, engages, and it dispenses water throughout the area. The importance of caring about people and their goals and their projects, it's their homes, it's their livelihood, it's their families. These homes I inspect, that's a place where people make memories. These ground fault circuit interrupters are strategically located. They detect within a tenth of a second any grounding shorts between any conductors and will shut down the electricity going to this receptacle. All homes now requires us inspectors to look and make sure this has been etched. It's a little identification saying this is tempered safety glazing. Somebody goes through it on accident, that it'll shatter like a web and will not char like shards of glass. This is another way of utilizing technology to keep everyone safe and the occupants in the dwelling. Right here you'll notice the interconnected smoke and carbon monoxide alarm. It's all connected and communicates. If there's a fire or some heat source going on down here, it'll trigger all the other alarms on the second level and throughout the whole entire dwelling. That's what we mean by interconnected smoke and carbon monoxide alarm. There's two components in a bedroom when you have a window. One is energy efficient. It's a dual glaze window. It's energy compliant, has low solar heat gain coefficient values and U values. And that creates an energy efficient structure. But the other component is egress. For firemen or emergency first responders, to get into this window, access it to help the threat within or from without. Nothing can be greater than 44 inches from the finished floor surface up to the window sill. Minimum 20 inches wide, can be greater, and no lower than 24 inches high. That's an egress emergency window. And in the attic space here, the crawl space, it's in the closet, but we have R38 insulation throughout. And that is a higher level of compliance that the city requires. The rulers that are in the attic shows the inspector that it's met the certain height requirement for so much insulation blown in that is required throughout the whole attic space. Right here, as we were talking before about the sliding glass doors, this is a hazardous area. You're in there with water, soap, and you could easily fall. Well, this is also a tempered safety glass, and it's etched right there. As a building inspector, we look at that. That's super important. This window right here as well, it's within the clearances of a bathtub shower, and that is also has to be required. And the code requires a front door to be minimum 32 inches wide and 78 inches tall, unobstructed. This is a ground fault circuit interrupter for the exterior use, but if you'll notice, it has a bubble cover, and it's tamper resistant, and it's also water resistant. This is a placard or identification. It shows somebody who's working on the system, or first responders if they have to climb up on the roof, that they know that there's a PV solar system. There's another source of energy here, and we need to disconnect it for emergency purposes. This is the main electrical service panel, and you'll see here that everything's labeled. We require that at final inspection, that everything's labeled. We'll also require a dedicated circuit for a fire bell. This is the tankless water heater vent. They all do it a little bit differently, but here it's where it exhausts out any gases, harmful gases, away from the structure. We've covered a lot. We have a pretty safe structure and building here. When a safe home like this is built to the current codes, it's not only safe for the neighborhood, it's safe for the community. Knowing that it's safe and that I've done everything I can per the approved set of plans gives me a sense of pride, and that I did a good job and I did everything I could for this family and for the city.